media?
Obviously really happy. Advancing penalties have been tough for us in the Big Ten. Also, Maryland is they're a really good opponent. We've battled them in some games. I don't know how many ties we've had and back and forth. I mean, it's a really good soccer game, and I think certainly the fans of soccer would enjoy today. Both teams go out and play, and we got playmakers on both teams that really made this an entertaining game on both sides. They'll do well in the tournament. Our guys, I'm just really happy that we get to another final. And again, getting back to the penalties, it's been a tough run for us in the Big Ten. So to kind of turn the script, and that's kind of the story of this year's team. Like, we've been really close the last couple of years, and now, we got the regular season, and now we're 90 minutes away from a postseason. So I really like the mentality. I'm really happy for the guys, and I know we'll be really excited to play whomever on Sunday.
What can you say about Trey Muse just stepping up again in penalties like he did last year?
Yeah, he loves the moment. I mean, that's the most important. He's pushed every day by a couple of guys in training that are phenomenal at shot stopping on penalties in particular, and he loves the moment. And you gotta love that for your goalkeeper and obviously your key shooters. And can't say enough about Trey. He's been great for us, obviously, since the moment he arrived.
How confident were you in Corey Thomas just putting him as your fifth PK taker?
Well, Corey's one of these that Corey doesn't think much about it. I mean, he's got ice in his veins. The coach in you worries, but you have to get back to the mentality of what you want your shooter to have, because I'm not taking the penalty. And he has no fear. He thinks he'll score every time, and that's what you want. And it's maybe unconventional, even his approach, and maybe even the way he strikes it, but he's been great in training. And we talked about him being, in the, four, five, six shooter, whatever it might be, and today was his day.
As a coach, what does it mean to you for your team to be on the other side of the coin, where last year you guys got knocked out in PKs in the championship, but this time around you guys won?
That's great. I mean, I really thought last year too, that game was a tough one too, because I thought we had so much of the game. Today I thought we had the better of it, certainly, if you add up the stretches, but Maryland had some great chances to win as well. So, that's harder when you don't advance in penalties, when you feel like you're just on top of the team, like we were last year in that final. Mm-hmm. So the script's a little different this year. It was just a really good game, and came down to, making some plays and penalties. And obviously that will give us confidence moving forward if we get into that situation again. I say, to go on any run, Big Ten or NCAA, you're probably going to have one game minimally that you probably get to penalties. If you keep advancing through those, call it eight games, mm-hmm. That you have an opportunity to advance through. So one's good to have in our belt.
For you, what will you be looking for on Sunday as to whether it will be a successful game for your guys?
Well, I mean, the matchup will be very different depending on who we face. With Michigan and Wisconsin, two different styles of teams. One will take space away, one will open the field up, and they have a few more playmakers, Michigan. Wisconsin has a wonderful belief. They have some really, really good young players that are finding that belief, and what a great job the staff has done with that group, losing quite a few senior stars from last year. So it will be a different challenge. All I know is that the guys will be looking at a trophy in the sideline, and that's all that's going to be in their mind, no matter who we play. We'll be ready for either team with a quick turnaround. The nice thing is we have both these teams already scouted, and we already know what to expect. It's just we got to go execute.
What can you say about Andrews' play today?
About whose?
Andrews.
Oh, I mean, it's every game. I keep saying, what new thing can he do for us? I don't know how many he went through today, but I've seen that at practice. And anyone that covers us probably has. I mean, he can do special things like that. And he left everything he could possibly have on that field. He wants us to win in such a good way, as a leader does. Certainly he's putting, I think, a stake in his ground for the player of the year. I continue to say that. I don't tell me another one out there that has done more than what Andrew Gutman's done.
Do you think the weather conditions made it a little tougher on your guys or just to play today, especially after the sleet and the snow started coming
down?
Yeah,
I mean, without a few of our national team guys, we were thinner in our rotation. Even a couple of our rotation guys didn't have a great week physically. That's why we didn't use Joe. Joe didn't have a great week physically. So I felt we got a little tired in that second half, and yet I felt the group that was on was the best group for us. We just had to kind of dig through, and that wind does take a little bit more out of you with running into that wind. So it feels like you played an extra 10 minutes on top of the overtime. So recovery is going to be the most important thing in the next 24 hours, and our staff's done a great job preparing that for that. We already have everything lined up. Just got to go out and execute.
So what does it say about this team to get a win in these type of conditions and with that adversity?
Good. I mean, this team likes these. I mean, they don't mind these conditions. I think that, again, our biggest strength as a team is they're flexible. They're balanced. They can win hot, cold, great game, ugly game. We still have our identity, but they can adjust, and that's what I love about this group.
The results from tomorrow are not going to affect you guys going forward. You go to the tournament no matter what, obviously, but how important is it to get this second leg of the Triple Crown, so to speak, that you guys set forth for yourself?
It's important. You know, certainly we're going to be in a situation where we wouldn't play first round based on our body of work, so recovery-wise, we'll be playing next Sunday. I don't know where we'll be in that seeding scenario, but you know, playing this game gives you another really good game that gives you that postseason. Anytime you can get another postseason game that has a title on the line, that's great. And obviously we have a lot of mature players that have already experienced that last year and the year before, but, you know, look up at Jack Mayer. I mean, what great experience is he getting? So, you know, we get in the tournament, you know, here in a week or so, he has another great game for him.
From another standpoint of actually getting the win, we talked about that before, of coming so close, but these guys are actually knocking these things off. They won the Big Ten title now, and now they're within reach of the tournament championship. How important is that mentally to win the title?
It's important. I think what the group got, that confidence of going 8-0, that's the most difficult thing, more difficult than doing this. Three games, certainly, because you have to do it over a span of time. And you have to deal with different elements, guys in and out, because it's a longer period of time. That was a great testament to this group. This is just, you want to win another title. And to do it, you know, in our home state, I think the fans will hopefully be out in full force Sunday to help give us the best advantage we can have up here in Westfield. This has become a good second home to us.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.